This works really well when the person you're handing it to has never seen such a thing and it's a complete mystery. The difference between this box and an ordinary box is this has a little display here and a button here. You don't know what's in the box. You push the button, the display lights up and it tells you distance 312 miles or distance 2.3 miles and it shuts itself off. That's the only clue you have that you've got to take this box somewhere to get it to open. Similar to geocaching, you've got to take it to the magic spot, and it's up to you to figure out where that magic spot is. You only get 50 attempts of pushing the button to get the box open before it seals forever. When the little controller detects that you have reached the magic spot, it sends a signal to the motor, or the motor unclicks the latch, and finally your friend, whoever you gave the box to as a present, finally can open it up and see what little treasures you placed inside it. If you're gonna send someone on a reverse geocache puzzle adventure, you gotta think about three things. You gotta think about who the recipient is, you gotta think about what destination you've planned for them, and you've gotta think about what you're gonna put in the box. This fellow who was going to send his father on an adventure wrote me last month. His dad's a little bit infirm and it was a 100-mile journey. And finally did get to the destination and he met his son there. And his dad said, "This is the best present I've ever gotten." He's 80 years old and this was the best present I've ever gotten. It's not just the box, but you know, the whole adventure.